Real life.
Okay, I'll start this program. Good evening. Okay, this is an evening program. So good evening, everyone. Welcome to Design Up Close, Design and Contemporary Lifestyle keynote presentation with Christian Tomadini of Lovely Vidina. So Design Up Close is Museum Macan and BWR Design, a new program series dedicated to the practice and theory of design. Creating links between designers and local design issues, the program consists of a regular keynote lecture, which is happening now, paired with a mentoring and open review program, which has we had done in May, if I'm not mistaken. This program is supported by Himpunan Desainer Interior Indonesia, or HDII, Aliansi Desainer Produk Industri Indonesia, ADPII, ITB, Institut Teknologi Bandung, dan Bandung Creative City Forum, BCCF. This program is also powered by Cisco. So for tonight's program will be moderated by our design and contemporary lifestyle mentor, Mas Eugenio Hendro. So Jakarta-based designer Eugenio Hendro received a design degree from Institut Teknologi Bandung. His studies focus on designing objects and furniture, merging various cultural contexts, combining new technology with traditional craftsmanship in order to highlight multifaceted beauty of the materials and draw renewed attention to small details. So without further ado, Mas Yujin, I'll give the stage to you.
Thank you so much, Widi. Okay, our session for today, well, good evening, everyone. Our session for today will be design and contemporary lifestyle. So I will read something to you guys. As we all know, it is a human nature to keep searching for a lifestyle that is comfortable for us. Well, today.
Well, good evening, everyone. Our session for today.
Sorry, that. Okay. Today, there are many lifestyle options people can try to adapt, from minimalist living to mobile residences. The changes of lifestyle in the contemporary society brought consequences into design thinking process and even to the executions. As a designer, how do we deal with the ever-changing society, ever-changing sites and situations? Do we adapt and adjust? Do we offer new options? Or do we design something that is versatile to all lifestyles? How do designers prioritize, consider, and negotiate the design to fit with the contemporary lifestyles? The cardinal points of contemporary furnitures are simplicity, practicality, and attention to aesthetics. Therefore, contemporary furniture represent the essence of innovations of the moment. For today, in Design Up Close today, we are talking about design and contemporary lifestyle with our keynote presentations prepared by Christian Tomadini, the CEO of Lovely Vidina. We will share about what is design in today's life, the way design responds to support the lifestyle that emerge during the current situations while maintaining the sustainability factor to reduce negative impact on the environment and health. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming Christian Tomadini. Please, Christian.
Christian, you forgot to unmute.
Okay, very nice to meet you. Very nice to meet you. And thank you very much, Eugene, for your introduction. I'm very happy to be here with you today. I preferred to be there with you in Indonesia, but yeah, it's not bad. Also here in Martignacco, in Friuli, is not bad. I'm very happy to speak with you about these matters today, because I think that during last months, during last weeks, particularly, everything is changing so fast, speaking about design and lifestyle. Because if you think about only about the masks, every day something change in, also in the shape and the colors and the design of the mask, and is changing every day, is something is changing in our lifestyle. I would like to introduce my keynote, sharing with you some provocations, some ideas that could bring us through the discover of La Cildina, of the design and of the sustainability. That is, the, I think, a main aspect that we are going through during last months, also at La Cildina. I will go now through the presentation, and okay, I will share my video. That's me, but it's not important to see me. And that is the main matter of our meeting today: design and contemporary lifestyle. I was some days ago very impressed about this picture that tells design your life. It's not my idea, it's something that I find on the internet and really is a bestseller from Bill Barnett and Dave Evans. They sold a lot of this book. That speaks about the design of your life. And then the question is, what is design? Design is more than what we mean every day, speaking about the shape of a car or speaking about the trousers and the fashion or the machine that makes the coffee. Design is a project, a very big project that takes together many, many aspects. And then that is very, very important, because design your life takes together design and life, lifestyle. The same is Design for Life, that is a TV serial from the BBC Two, conducted by a very famous designer all over the world, and that takes together different architects and young designers from all over the world, speaking about how the design affects our life, how design could improve, but could also change, radically change, with as a revolution our lives. And speaking about this is very interesting, and many, many times I would like to go this definition and the pictures that I will share after that. Design is a plan or drawing produced to show the look and function of workings of a building, of a garment and other objects before it is made. And then it is not only the shape, the color, it is a project, it is a document, it is a thought that becomes before. It is something that is more than very often we mean with the word design. It is something that is very, very deeply affecting our life every day. And speaking about this, I would like to show you some pictures. These are three cars that born in just during the Second War. The first is 2CV, the Citroën 2CV. This is the Beetle, maybe some of you recognize, because is one of the best seller cars all over the world. And this last is the Topolino. If you go through these three pictures, you find very, very deep similarities, because the shape of every one of these cars is very similar. You see the part in front of the car, you see the glasses, you see also the shape of the side of the car, everything seems very, very similar. And think about, this is from France, this is from Germany, and this is from Italy. Despite of the similarities that you have in the shape and in the dimensions of the cars, at the beginning, there are three completely different projects. And then this was thought, the project for the design of this car at the beginning for the Citroën was to have something, to have a car that could improve the mobility of the farmers that need a car to go through the fields, bringing the eggs, bringing the wine, and going through very bad roads without broke anything inside the car. This is a car that that time when they thought and they project the car, they decided to have something where people can go through the motorways of the Germany that time, but also where the soldiers, the German soldiers during the Second War, could also bring guns inside to go to the war and to fight to the war. And this last was the Topolino, is the smallest car that you can find in the history of the cars because of the very small roads in our very ancient, very old cities, where the streets were very, very small, very little, and then they need to go through these roads. And know the Beetle and know the Citroën 2 CV going through that roads. Consider that despite the same shape, you have three completely different designs, three completely different projects. And believe me, if you go, sorry, I will try to go back. If you go through, if you go driving, if you go trying to drive these cars, the feeling that you have is completely different. And this affected every day our lives. The design, the project in the car field, the design in the fashion, the design, especially the design in the furniture, affect every day our life. And this is very important to understand, because also a very revolutionary aspect that we are facing every day with the COVID will change our daily life also in the design, in the project, and in the I don't know, in the shapes and in the colors that we will prefer to use in our spaces, in our workplaces, and so on. And then it is very interesting to speak about in the different fields, design, affect lifestyle, affect fashion, affect the day life of everybody. It is a deep and a strong effect that we have to consider every day. And design also is affected by art, because the art have the more revolutionary effects in our lifetime every day, with the colors, with the innovation of the thought that the artist bring to the people every day. And then it is very, very important to consider that not only the shape, not only the color, not only the sketch that we do on a product and on a project are very important. It is important the history, it is important the place where people live, it is important also the feeling that you have when you develop a project, when you develop a design for in every different field. And then it is very important to introduce this matter and to better understand why very often Italian design is preferred to many other designs in especially in car design, in furniture design, because the history, because the art that our country had in its past, in the past centuries, really deeply affected our way to imagine the future, our way to imagine shapes, our way to imagine design in every different field. This is very important to understand. I will go another time through the presentation, because it is interesting to have another look to the three pictures that I show you, because please feel the shape, feel the aspects that these three projects had in the past, but consider that these three design projects have very different thoughts at the beginning, a very different imagination that becomes to the same, in some ways, the same use, because the three cars both are to drive and to go to one place to another. And then it is very interesting to consider all these aspects that affect every day our lifestyle. That is the someone way of living, is the things, the lifestyle is the things that a group of people usually do, is what we are usually what we like to do in our life every day. And then I would like now to show you a small video that goes through the history of our company and explain something about on how we do, how we like to do, and how we prefer to live our nowadays work in the design field. I will go through this video that I will share now.
There are actions that are more than simple movements. Some actions are special, unique. They reveal the culture behind their creation and perfection. They carry the love and care of their makers in them. They are passed on and enriched, becoming new, better actions. Their roots lie in one area, but they can communicate with the whole world. They are actions that conceal a universe, and they are the only ones capable of showing us its wonders. La Cividina. Welcome to the place where actions become beauty. With his wife Diletta alongside him, in 1976, Carlo Gulfoni decided to showcase all of his experience by presenting the world with the unique value of Italian craft traditions. The art of producing beautiful, practical creations with unchanging passion. La Cividina was launched. Armchairs and sofas began to take shape. Design projects were brought to fruition, and they were ready to conquer the world. Passion and knowledge were passed down from father to son at La Cividina in a handover filled with pride and respect. Today, Fulvio and his partner Paola are at the helm of an internationally renowned business. They have a clear, dynamic business vision with a focus on the future and the same vivacity as ever. Every La Cividina creation is the result of perfect processes, from design to production. A careful selection of structures and materials. Special manufacturing procedures that are still carried out by hand. Care and precise attention to detail. This is the timeless beauty of Italian-made products. A natural combination of craftsmanship and cutting-edge industrial technology enables La Cividina to face any challenge. Its production facilities can cater to the needs of customers from all over the world while constantly making the most of the distinctive features of all projects. Every creation is the product of constant dialogue between the designer and the company. The creative process is never an end in itself, and it finds its fullest expression in practicality and aesthetics. In perfect balance between shape and substance, the boundary between products and works of art disappears. Today, La Cividina's collections are chosen for use in public spaces and private dwellings all over the world. Design, concreteness, originality, and reliability are the daily objectives for which we are renowned across the globe. Thanks to products that encapsulate the culture, experience, and passion of their creators. La Cividina, when actions create beauty.
Here we are. I hope that you had the possibility to go through all. I'm sorry, what is? Okay. I hope that you had the possibility to go through all the length of the video and considering what we every day do. Because we do every day all the things that you that you have the possibility to see on the video. We are not only a brand, we have a manufacturing plant with best craftsmanship all over the world. Every day we come together to do something that clean the borders to the creativity and the things that we every day can also deliver all over the world. And then projects that are born through the partnership of international designers and that also bring to us the possibility to share every day different cultures, every day speaks in different languages, every day feels really different ways to design, different ways to think, and different ways to live. And this is, I think that this is really what we mean with lifestyle. If we go through the history, I will use now another presentation. Sorry, Eugene,
yes.
Is there any question? Is there any suggestion about how we are going on?
No, but everything is clear, so please continue.
Okay, thank you very much. And then I will share now the content of a presentation that shows something more about the history, about about our company. La Cividina, born in 1976 by the hand of Carlo Bulfoni, that is the father of Mr. Fulvio Bulfoni, that you already seen in the video before. Carlo had the possibility to work and to share the first years of his working experience, his job, to one of the best schools of craftsmanship for the upholstery products in the north of Italy. From these schools, many best producers like Moroso, like Cassina, at the same school and at the same teachers, and then he started his experience when he was only 14 years old. And then year by year he improved the company, And for 20 years, he worked in the most prestigious laboratories in the area, acquiring very high knowledge for the realization of upholsteries. Every day, we go through the heritage of the school. We go through the craftsmanship that everybody now would like to maintain as a very big value in his craftsmanship. Because there are some jobs, some things that we do every day in our factory that you can do only by hand. You can do only very deep experience. And then working in high-level laboratories, he had the good fortune to work for the development of prototypes designed by some of the most important designers in the 60s and in the 70s. And from this experience, after some years, La Cividina had the possibility to build the new production plant to open his own business, going also through the developing of his own pieces, design pieces. And then year by year, La Cividina had the possibility to introduce new products, to introduce new partnership with designers that becomes from all over the world, and also to present very, very revolutionary shapes and design that nowadays are still in our general catalog. And in at about the late 90s, La Cividina had the possibility to build and to present his first own general catalog. Every piece at La Cividina is made by hand, but I will show you now a very interesting video that very well explains these aspects. And the quality is totally assured, because we use also machineries for cutting the fabrics. We use completely human quality control on the leathers. We use the selection of the thickness, the selection of the pieces of the leathers only when we obtain the leather to work on. And then only when you have the piece of the leather ready in your hands. And then we have a quality controlled seaming, because all our sewing and seaming machines have the possibility to check with very deep detail the quality of the work and the job that the people is doing. We also use reinforced carbon fiber tapes in all our sewings, and then consider that all the covers of our furniture have the carbon tape to assure lifetime quality of the product. We use wood and certified wood, and only certified wood for the structures. And sometimes, like in the ARIA project, we use also steel structures that have the possibility to use small thickness and small pieces compared to the wood. We use only certified flame retardant polyurethane foam, polyester fiber, 100% polyester fiber, and every time manual finishing on curved forms. And this is the team of the people that every day works to manage and control all the quality at La Cividina. the upholstery is something that gives to the product the final shape and the final characteristic with the elegance and with the finishing, the details of the product that go through the world. And these are some pictures of the designers. This is Andrea Steidel, that every day are in partnership with our company. But in our general catalog, there are very worldwide famous designers like Pierre Polen, Antonio Rodriguez, Constance Gisset, and Sebastian Merkner, and very well known like Antonino Shortino, that is firstly is an artist, but very often he likes to design something that also goes through the industrial production and becomes a bestseller, like the Turi-Turi and the Accursio table that you will find in our collections. The Pinch that won the Compasso d'Oro prize some years ago, the Puro Famos with Mill, very, very deep and large and wide types of products, collections that we collect together in a very wide general catalog that nowadays has about 600 pages of very well pictured, very well done pictures and technical details. La Cividina in numbers, because it is very important also to have a picture of what we do every day in our company. At the beginning, in 1976, La Cividina worked only in Italy, only for Italian clients, with almost four clients and four artisans that are working with, and zero designers, because at the beginning we worked only for other companies doing only prototypes. And the manufacturing plant was very, very small. In the second stage, and then at the beginning of this century, we had clients in five countries with 52 clients totally, 28 artisans and three designers. Nowadays, we have 72 countries where we are exporting our products. We have more than 1,800 clients, 66 artisans, craftsmanships work with us, and more than 20 designers, because last year we had 20 totally. This year we will introduce three new, brand new designers that are collaborating with our company. The company, the manufacturing plant of the company nowadays is more than double. And we have also a beautiful, a very wide, beautiful showroom in the ancient elementary school of the small town where we live, that is Martignacco, not so far from Venice in Friuli Venezia Giulia. Beautiful place with green grass around, not so far from mountains, not so far from the sea, from the beaches. A very, very beautiful place to stay, but also where the people very stay very well. Please come and visit us to La Cividina showroom and offices. We are also building the new factory just during this day. These are pictures that are taken in some days ago. We are building the new factory because despite the COVID, despite all the things that we are living and we are facing, We have many, many projects that grown up all over the world, and with the biggest and the very important interior design and architect studios. And then we decided to go through the building of a very big new production plant that in 2021 become this beautiful architecture, this beautiful black architecture surrounded by green grass, by where all the people will work near very big windows that are faced to the green grass. And then also the stay inside our production plan will be great, will be well, and will be very, very fine. And then a sort of development, revolutionary development that we are going through. And I have the pleasure and I'm proud to share this path with Mr. Fulvio Bulfoni and Mr. His wife, Mrs. Paola, that are the president and vice president of our company, and then every day are directly involved in everything happens in the company. And then this is in some picture and in some detail, the history and the content of what we do every day at La Cividina. La Cividina nowadays is also very well explained through effective, really effective website that I will go to share with you now to. Okay, here we are. Sorry. To explain how we prefer, how we would like to show our collections, our way to do the things every day. And then from the home page, where we will show every day different things about the products, about the events, about the new collections. From the home page, you can go through the content of the website and then the partnership with El Decor Italia for a very important digital exhibition that they are still going through in their website, but also the presentation of the new products, projects, because every day we would like to show you the projects that we do all around the world with the same, with the different products that we have in our general catalog. Also the fairs. Unfortunately, this year we had the possibility to show our products only to Stockholm Furniture Fair in February, because as you you well know, all the fairs from March and still now are cancelled and becomes delayed to the 2021. And then Stockholm Furniture Fair has been the last fair that we had in furniture market in 2020. For us, it has been a very important fair, because many people went to our booth, many people shared the new collections that we presented there, but we missed the Salone del Mobile, where we would like to show the news, we would like to show the new collections of 2020 April Salone del Mobile. At the beginning of I will go now also through the new collections and through the platform lacividina.is, that is a sort of laboratory where we would like to share with the people our thoughts, our projects, our thinking, like a think tank, like a place where to share, where to comment, where to discuss different aspects that we face every day in our work. And then for sure the new collections, but also we would like to speak about acoustic comfort. That is something that nowadays is particularly important in design, not only in furniture design, in architecture, in car design, in hospitality design. Everywhere, the acoustic comfort nowadays is one of the most important aspects that we have to consider. And in the same way, we face every day the sustainability. Sustainability is not only certifications. Sustainability is not only something that you have to show and that consider the respect to the environment, but sustainability is something that is 360 degrees around our life and then takes everybody in his life to pay attention to the place where we work, to pay attention on how we do our products, the material that we are using, also the possibility to use materials that at the end of the life of the products can be separated. And then there are a lot of arguments that we can go through during our meeting today. I would like to show you something just about sustainability, because it is very important to speak about how we use doing, making, and building our products, and how you can find the same contents also on the website, how you really very well understand on the manufacturing of our products. If you go on the website lacivdina.is and in the root sustainability, you will find this small video that shows very well on how we do all our products. And then beginning with a wooden structure that is FSC certificated, and then Forest Saving Council certificated, and then all the wood that we use in our products becomes from certificated forest and give to the product the best certification in respect to the environment for the forests that we are using. The all the plywood and the small layers, small thickness layers that we use for the fiber boards are completely formaldehyde free and are completely CARB compliant. And then all our products are ready to go in the United States and all the countries that embrace the United States normatives and standards because are completely formaldehyde free and are ready to go in the places where you need something that totally do not emit VOC and then nocive volatile gases. All the structures are very resistant and all the seatings are obtained with safe and strong webbing straps that give you the best comfort, but that give you also the best quality in the durability of the product. Consider that Also, the straps are fixed to the structure with techniques that let you have the complete separability of the nylon material of the straps from the wooden structure. And then at the end of the life of the product, by hand, you can take over the straps from the structure to obtain different raw materials to waste in the best way, respecting the environment. And then the total separability is also for the foams, the polyurethane foams that are all certificated also against the fire. And then all the products could have the possibility to be used in high transit areas like airports, like hotels, meeting rooms, and so on. And all the upholstering is done using different density, sitting different density polyurethanes that give you the best performance in ergonomics and in comfort. That package, together with the 100% polyester fiber that give you also the irresistible touch on the surface, the package together give you also very high acoustic comfort, because the empty spaces inside the wooden frame, the open cell foams that we use for the upholstering, together with the polyester fiber and together with the cover, and we use usually very high quality fabrics like the Allendale by Quadrat, give you everything. All these things give you a great performance in acoustic comfort. And then if you take a piece of La Civitina, like the guest or like the pinch, you have a very, very good improvement of the sound environment inside your rooms. This is very important. It's similar when you goes in when you go in an empty room, and after a while, you install you put some carpets in the flooring. You feel that something changed in acoustics. With the La Civitina products that are very well designed for this aspect, you can really have a good improvement of the acoustic comfort. And then irresistible touch with the polyester fiber and with the best fabrics from the best manufacturers all over the world for an impeccable made in Italy product. This is what we do every day. This is something that goes through the principle of the sustainability, through the main argument of the sustainability, going through very good raw materials, going through the design, and going through the partnership of the designers that let you have also very, very interesting shapes for the product. All the products of La Civitina are collected in the website, and you will find everything in the product family collection. I also could turn in English for the language. Okay. And you have the possibility to go through the families that are very well displayed, very well shown with the name of the collection and a picture that shows you the brief that we shared with the designer when we start our collaboration with him. And then when we decide to develop the project with Sebastian Erkner, and then when we decided to go through the ALA collection, we would like to develop a product that can fit perfectly in a very high designed environment like this private villa, but in the same time, going through the pictures of the collection, you could understand that you have the possibility to, this is the same villa with the same product, but you have also the possibility to go through offices like this one and to create very elegant spaces in very different places, in very different interiors. And then for all the products of our company, you will find directly in the first pages of the website many, many pictures that very well show the contents of the collection. Going and scrolling down, you have all the technicalities of the collections, and then the data sheet, the 2D, the 3D, the upholsteries, and so on, the sections, but you have also the possibility to go through the references all over the world. Very interesting, because together with the different products, in the different projects, you will find the best signs of the best architecture firms all over the world. In very first one, that is an hotel in Budapest, not so far from Italy, that collect together many different products from La Cividina. And then together with the ala that we are looking on some minutes ago, and all the references, all the projects have the selection of the products that you have inside the project. And then, I don't know, if I like the Turi-Turi table, I can go directly to the Turi-Turi collection area and to see the different pictures of this table, to see also, I don't know, some more details about the designer. And then you can click directly on the name of the designer to discover his biography, to enjoy the interview directly connected with the YouTube, and to go through all the collections with that the same designer did for our company. And then, I don't know, I like very much the Plof Ottoman. I have the picture of the product, but in the same way that we already did, I have also the data sheet and so on, and all the characteristics of the product of that designer. If we go, I don't know, through the Scancaro, that is another really joyful and beautiful collection designed by Antonino Shortino, and we are speaking about table, we have so many references to go through, like the EIM clinic in Spain. You can find the Osaka sofa, you can find the tables that we are looking on in the pictures and in the previous, and many other pieces for the same project. If I will go through the Osaka sofa, that is one of the bestsellers of our company, we discover a project that born in 1967. And it is still one of the best furniture design projects that you can find all over the world. The French designer Pierre Collin, that time in 1967, was in charge of the government design of all the sittings or of all the museums in Paris. And then if you go to the Louvre, if you go in the best museums in Paris, you will find the Pierre Polin pieces all over the spaces. I would like now to show you this a small video that show how Pierre Polan, that time in 1967, was so revolutionary in his job. Here we are. Consider that Osaka is still the only bending sofa all over the world nowadays, because with the Osaka, you can decide whenever you want to change its shape, to change its position very easily, without dismounting, without dismantling anything, only bending, only curving the shape of the sofa. It is very, very important and very interesting, because I repeat, it is, Osaka is the only bending sofa all over the world. It's for that it is still our bestseller for the sofas in all over the world, in the best projects that you can find. It is very simple, because it uses a steel frame together with the polyurethane foams, and also together with a cover that is in very high quality. Very high quality materials. With this product, Louis Vuitton, I think that everybody well known as one of the best fashion designers in the history, Louis Vuitton uses still today about 420 Osaka sofas to do the runways all over the world. And then with the same sofas that they move and they change the shapes and they go all around the world, people sit on the sofas and the models walk through for the runway and to show fashion garments that Louis Vuitton designed. Consider also, but I cannot show you, maybe at the end of our meeting we also can look at it. We also did the main headquarter of Ferrari with Osaka. And then he is very well known also from the best brands, and it is really a proud for us to have the possibility to share this product all around the world. From the website, you can go also through the social network pages of our company. And at the end of every page, you have the direct link to the Facebook, to the Instagram, to the LinkedIn, and so on. But I like very much to show you the Pinterest, because it is a very useful and effective tool that the social networks nowadays let you use to have inspiration. Directly in the home page of the La Cividina Pinterest boards, you have the possibility to go through many different matters, many different suggestions, like, I don't know, the color of the year 2020. Here you will find all the different La Cividina collections that we did in the classic blue color that Pantone declared this year as the color of the year, as the color of the best inspiration of 2020 year. And then here you can find many different pieces with this classic blue color. But in the same way, you can have also many different inspirations from the board of the designers, where we collect also interviews, pictures of the work that we do with the designers every year, a lot of videos that shows also the details on the work that on the job that we do with the designers, and are very, very interesting, because here, collected together, we have a lot of materials that we can go through to better understand and to better know our company. I can go also through the new collections 2020 board that put together all the pictures of all the different collections of the company, but as usually we have in the social networks, without an explanation, without a content, without a technical detail on the different pieces, on the different collection. And then for this, you can go back to the main website, you can go back to the product area, and you will find also all the explanation and all the pictures of all the 2020 new collections. If you also go through the lacividina.is new collection 2020 area of the website, you can have the possibility to see the introduction video that is it is interesting. I think that we can share together also this video that very well show and very well explain the our imagination for 2020 collections. Oh, sorry.
Ogni prodotto alla Cividina nasce da un'esigenza del mercato, ma la richiesta più preziosa è quando un tuo cliente dice: voglio venire a vedere.
Questi siamo noi e questa è la Cividina.
Sustain our ability significa credere nella propria competenza, nel territorio e nel fatto che ogni prodotto deve essere realmente sostenibile.
Sostenibilità, separabilità e riduzione dell'inquinamento acustico sono nel futuro del design. Già oggi tutte le collezioni La Cividina rispondono a questo trend. Bernard è la nuova poltroncina disegnata da Nina Meyer per la Cividina. Perfetta per una camera d'albergo, grazie alle dimensioni contenute, ma perfetta anche negli ampi spazi collettivi.
Schienale e bracciolo di Bernard sono realizzati con moduli identici e possono variare la propria funzione a seconda della direzione in cui ci si vuole sedere.
La collezione Bernard si compone di diversi elementi: poltroncina con bracciolo, singolo o doppio, puff, lounge chair e divano a due o tre posti, due tavolini di diverse dimensioni caratterizzati dalla stessa struttura portante della seduta completano la proposta di Nina Meyer per la Cividina.
Couchette si ispira alle classiche cuccette dei treni che, grazie all'interpretazione di Luci di Pevere, diventano confortevoli stanze di diverse dimensioni. Un sistema di sedute con 38 elementi per creare ambienti di privacy adattabili a qualsiasi contesto. Gli accessori, tra cui tavolini, connessioni elettriche, USB e ganci a pendiabito, trasformano couchette in spazi di lavoro temporanei e estremamente silenziosi.
Le collezioni La Cividina hanno un vantaggio unico: il comfort acustico. La struttura in legno, espanso a quote differenziate e fibra poliestere garantiscono ottime prestazioni di fonoassorbenza. Un effetto amplificato dalle pareti di couchette, posizionabili in qualunque punto del divano. Swale è stata progettata insieme a Gordon Guillaumier per offrire al settore contra, come al residenziale, una poltrona singola, molto comoda e con una progettazione complessa che esalta le capacità tecniche della Cividina. Ancora una volta, una seduta all'insegna della sostenibilità, con tutti gli elementi separabili e con ottime doti acustiche.
Lo speciale comfort di Swale è ottenuto con la tiratura a mano delle cinghie elastiche e una precisione millimetrica nella distribuzione dei volumi. La curvatura è perfetta, grazie alla capacità della Cividina di modellare qualsiasi forma. Questa lounge, con o senza posatesta, è sostenuta da una struttura simmetrica in metallo.
Il secondo progetto, sviluppato con Gordon Guillaumier, celebra il design di Gioponti e degli anni 70. Si chiama Farlap ed è una sedia a sdraio ideata per studiare, lavorare e pensare.
Alta e composta, con uno schienale che si allunga verso l'alto, consente una postura eretta e confortevole. La scelta progettuale di una struttura a vista, qui è portata all'estremo con un risultato di solidità e raffinata geometria. Questo è il team La Cividina, pronto ad incontrarvi per parlare di nuovi progetti insieme.
And this is the way that we do all our videos, all our things every day. It is, I don't know, it is also very, very simpatico, we say in Italian, this game that we did with we sustain our ability, that becomes sustainability. It is, I don't know, a game that we did during a sort of brainstorming before the video, and becomes our, I don't know, brief during the explanation of the videos. In the same way, and on the same website, you can go through the virtual showroom that puts together the different pieces of La Cividina, not only the news, but also if you see here the Osaka, you can also press on the information dot and you can have the possibility to go through the website to see the contents and to see all the things that we need about the collections. And you can go through the different proposals of 2020 new collections. It is very interesting to spend a few minutes on the couchette, that is a system, as you can see, a system that you let you have many different lengths, many different angles for the curves, many different evolutions of the development of the system that can also let you have a standalone eyelids that seems UFO, that's UFO objects, but also small and very elegant sofas, and you will find another time, you will find everything also in the general website. But during the development of the couchette, it was the end of February, I had also the worrying to understand better if this type of product could be interesting after the COVID, because if you consider this type of development of the product it seems that is a inno to stay together, big hugs, make love, not war. It is perfect imaginary world. But with the COVID, we immediately turn the project in this new typology of side panels that let you have also private areas that you can very well understand in the pages of the collection, in the main website, in the general website, because here you have also the explanation with, as you can see, the panels with the hangers for the jacket, the side tables with the USB power plug, and then everything you need to create small working places, small areas, small private areas where to stay safe and very comfortable with two people together, one people sitting, and then many different possibilities, and also the possibility to remove the panels when you will be safe without the COVID. And then the elegance and the effectiveness of the system is not affected by the panels, because you can decide to put in or to remove the panels whenever you want, in every time you want, from the different compositions of the couchette product. Another very beautiful product that we presented this year is the Farlap. I love this this product because it is inspired by, I'm sorry, I missed the right way to go. Okay, because it is inspired to a very old project of Gio Ponti, and is the Farlap. It is likely similar to a decking chair, and it is very comfortable, and it is something that bring your mind, bring your thoughts to the 60s, with this particular shape, with this particular design that is very interesting, not only for the residential, but also for the country market. And consider that together with wooden structure for the backrest and for the seating, metal structure that you can paint with the colors that you want. It is very well explained in the picture of the three pieces, where you have white, black, and dark red color for the structure, and then wooden structure, metal structure for the legs, and very high quality fabrics for a product made in Italy, completely made by hand in Italy, cost around 1,200 euros. 1,200 euros is a very interesting cost to have a piece, a made in Italy piece, completely done by hand. And then a lot of things that every day bring La Cividina on the tables of the architects, on the tables of the people that project, design, the working and sharing spaces all over the world. A best instrument that you can also find in our website is the I'm sorry, I will change another time in English, is the configurator, is the app. You can download the La Cividina app from the Apple Store, from the for the Windows, for the Mac OS versions, and then with La Cividina app you will have all the products of La Cividina together in the same instrument, and now I will show you, together with the possibility to change fabrics, to change colors of the legs, and so on. And then from the website, from the official website, you can download the different versions of the app. When you will have the app in your laptop, in your PC, you can start and you can go through the La Cividina world. Sorry, I will go now through the sharing of the right window. I'm waiting to start the app. Okay, here we are. Eugene, help me.
Yes.
Is the app online?
Yes, I can see.
Ah, okay. Okay, great. And then I will go now through the configuration. You see, all the models of La Cividina are together in the same internet place, together with the possibility to change everything about you have all the description, you have the possibility to change all the fabrics, you have the possibility to change also the color of the legs, you have the possibility to change everything about the products, you have the online live dimensions of all the products, you have the possibility to go through all the collections. But very interesting, because for the systems you have also the possibility to compose different different compositions like this one, because if you press on the edit button, you can have the possibility to put together different pieces, also turning around, also putting different configuration, and to save and to have your configuration already ready to be explored and to be changed in all the fabrics and the things that you can do in all the different collections. But very interesting is also the planner that let you have the possibility to put different pieces inside, and then I don't know, I put one armchair, I can also modify the dimensions of the room to have the same dimensions that I have in my plan, in my design, and to put together different pieces, also changing the position, changing the direction, and putting, I don't know, also some coffee tables together, like the accursio and the turituri tables. Maybe you can also change the color. You can also put another coffee table, turituri, this one. That could be interesting. Okay, this is not the right one. It's so big. this is so big. Okay. And then all these things together to have a 3D explanation of the project, with the possibility to go through the different pieces with the name, the code, and all the finishings of all the pieces that you have in your project. And then a lot of possibilities, a lot of tools that let you have all the products of the company in your hands to put in the projects, and to bring back to our argument of today, to have the possibility to change and to improve your lifestyle with made in Italy products, very well done by hand. And then a lot of possibilities, a lot of I don't know, very easy different tools and configurations. I think that I could go forward with hours and hours of explanations and suggestions and moods, but I think that also that could be interesting to share some comments, to share some questions, and to have some time together to discuss about the arguments of this meeting today.
Yeah, very interesting. The presentation is really, really interesting. We see the history of La Cividina and the traditional craftsmanship of Italy, and it's interesting how it can still be relevant with the mission. So okay, we have a couple of questions waiting for you. First question from Hilda Averina. He asks, Christian, how to protect yourself optimally in activities outside, especially having to deal with the invisible virus with the number of cases increasing every day?
Luckily, the job that we will do, we do every day in our premises, in our factory, do not need small spaces, do not need to stay very near one to the other, because everybody, every craftsmanship have a lot of space around. They wear the masks, and we haven't had any infection in our company. The offices, the office where I am now, are divided by glasses all around, and then I can see everybody that is working around me, but we are very well protected around. But consider also that in our region, very few cases of infections, also at the beginning, and nowadays, fortunately, we have really, really very few cases. We are very, we paid a lot of attention. Consider also that Friulian people, because in the region where we live, that is Friuli Venezia Giulia. Friulian people is known all over the world as not so, I don't know, not so familiar people to have hugs together. We are a little bit, I don't know, reserved.
Not a hugger.
No, we are not huggers, no.
So is there any innovations in terms of material that you use in the La Cefidina furnitures? Like,
Yeah, it is a very interesting question. We immediately started in March, we immediately started to research fabrics and textiles that let you have the best, the maximum protection against the virus. We found some products, we found some textiles that are very high performance on this matter, but not you will never find something that is virus ready in some ways. You will find something that you can very well clean after the use, very well clean after the sitting, with high resistance, and then you will have a product that you can use and clean many more times without any wearing. This is very important because there are some misunderstandings on the market nowadays, because it is somebody that tell you that they have the textile that kill the virus. It is not real. It is not it is not possible. You can have fabrics where the virus stay in the on the surface, and then you can clean, and then you can have very high performance surfaces without any damage and infection after the use. This is the reality. This is the truth.
So there is an effort of using material, introducing new materials to the furniture in La Cefidina to be more relevant.
Okay,
we go to the next questions. It's from Farid Bima Ramadan. Company is from Gotukang. He has a very simple question regarding traditional axe feature design. So maybe what he wants to know is about how the traditional and feature design
fits together.
Yes.
It is a very interesting question because we have in our collections. I will show something through the sharing of the contents on the website. I will go now in the. Okay, here we are. Okay. If we go through the products families, you will find something also that bring you back to the past for the shapes and for the characteristics of the product. It is something like the LP. The LP is one of our first five bestseller products, and it has this very elegant, very thick wooden structure for the legs, together with the very comfortable seating with this big cushion. And the shapes and the characteristics go back, bring back to the traditional and classic shapes. But everything is done with the same craftsmanship, the same very high quality and very high resistance. And then this product that very well fit in a residential classic picture like this one could be also great in a project like the XO Hotel in Paris, where with the red velvet it is very elegant, but it is also a sort of remember the classic characteristic of the products. The same product in different, I don't know, Van Doorn and V in the Netherlands becomes very modern, becomes very well designed together with other products, like in Van Doorn in Amsterdam. And then there are a lot of products that could very well fit the classics, but that also will go through a very tight and slide design that could also fit very well the modern and the last trends in the furniture. There are so many pieces about the classics, like the Mon Petit Coeur. It is another example on how at La Cividina we do something that goes through classic shapes, but together with very high quality and very high level of design. It is interesting because in the same page you can scroll down and you can go through many different pieces, many different collections that puts together also the Serie 50, the serie 50. That is interesting because you have shapes and dimensions that goes back to the 50s with this shape that is it's very similar to some designs that we had in the past. And then yes, we have a sensibility also for the past design, for the shapes and the products that could fit very well also in a classic mood. We do not do anything like the Rinascimento, like the very rich details that we had during the last century, that during the centuries of Rinascimento, of the Austrian emperor, and so on.
Okay, we jump to the next questions from Gandhi. Is a minimalistic design for any space can be considered as a temporary lifestyle? Because there is a refraction of meaning between minimalistic design with contemporary style. How do you discuss?
Sorry, Eugene, I missed some words of your question. Sorry very much.
Okay. I repeat again. The question is a minimalistic design for any space can be considered as a contemporary lifestyle? Because there is a refraction of meaning between minimalistic design with contemporary style. How to differentiate? He want to know how to differentiate the concept of minimalistic design and contemporary lifestyles, contemporary design.
Well, it's a very, very difficult question. It is something that could also full pages of books. because the minimalistic design nowadays is especially very often used in the workplaces, in also in many private villas, in especially in common areas, in the airports, and so on. Because it is not more easy to do. It is not more useful than the traditional. But I don't know, maybe the minimalistic design could let you have a very comfortable place to stay and to use in your, I don't know, your own rests, in your own thoughts, without any disturb of shapes, of colors, that maybe after some times could also let you be, I don't know, it could pass through like the fashion. It could, the very rich design of some periods of our of the furniture history really have so much details, so much weight that brings in the space, and they also so much characterize the space that after some time you also feel bad, because you need to have something that you can shape and you can modify, you can adapt to your mood during your life, speaking about lifestyle. I don't know, speaking about the Osaka, you can bend, you can have a straight sofa, you can change the position, you can do everything. And also with a very minimalistic design, you can put a table together, you can change the color of the cover, you can change very easily the characteristic, also bringing with you the mood that you have for your environment, for your space. I don't know if is a good answer of this question, but it's a very difficult argument, very difficult, very deep question. I think that our company, in all the general catalog that you can go through, has a sort of a red line that connect all the collection from all the different designers, that is in a certain way the sign of La Cividina. And then you will find something that is common through all the collections, also if they become from different designers. There is a sort of red tape that takes everything together. And that is the important thing that we have to consider. In that way, you can choose different pieces with more classic, more modern, more contemporary, very different shapes and characteristics, but every time having a sort of connection with the mood of La Cividina.
I understand. It is a very deep question. So
yeah.
but good answer, Christian. I understand that.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll jump to another question. Because you develop a lot of design in company, how long usually it takes to develop design?
This time I will be very, very clear. Usually, everybody, because all over the world, all the big brands decide to present their news to the Salone del Mobile in April in Milano, because Milano is the international capital of the furniture design. And then every year, everybody decide to present different collection to Milan. Usually, we share the brief of the new product that we would like to introduce in the catalog just after the finishing of Salone del Mobile, and then just in May we are ready to share with the designers the brief of the new collections. We immediately start to develop the ideas and then to design the new collection in June. Usually in by the end of September, we have the prototypes of the collections. And in October, November, December, we usually meet the designer, we share with the designer all the details, all the development of the different shapes and the different characteristics, the colors, the fabrics that we will use in the new collection. And usually by the end of January, we are ready with the new products to take the shooting for the new catalogs, and in April to be ready to show the new collection to the Salone, already ready with the new catalogs with the price list, and already ready to be sold to the market. And then usually the development takes about 1 year, but we start immediately after the Salone, because at the Salone you have the feeling of the trends. At the Salone you have the feeling of what you did with the collection that we are presenting to the Salone, and then you have the feeling, you have the possibility to meet the designers, to share with them ideas and feelings on the moods and on the trends, and then so on, about 1 year, and to be ready with the products.
So it's approximately a year.
Yeah.
Because you need to present it in the Salone del Mobile.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. One of my friend asked, what is the meaning of La Cividina? Is there any?
Very interesting. Very interesting. Yeah, because I missed this information. La Cividina is the main street, the main road that during the Roman Emperor connect Rome, and then the capital of the Roman Emperor, Rome, to Cividale. Cividale is a small town that is not so far from Udine. I will show you on the maps. It could be interesting also to show where we are, because it is sometimes it is not easy to understand very well the local places of where we are. And then here we are in Italy. Here it is Rome. And we are in the northeast part of Italy, near the borders with Austria and Slovenia, near to the mountains, very, very beautiful place. And La Cividina is the main road that connects Rome, and then the road that goes through all the Italy to Cividale. Here now we go to
Christian,
Udine.
Green? Christian.
Okay. Here we are now, La Cividina, with also the showroom. You see the pictures, also the pictures of our showroom that is in the very big building that was the elementary school of Martignacco, with also the logos. You see, this is our headquarters and offices.
Jim, can you hear me?
And La Cividina, Via Cividina, you see here, oh, sorry, Via Cividina was the road that connected together Rome to Cividale. Cividale is here, is a beautiful city protected by the UNESCO, because here in Cividale you have very, very important art pieces from very important artists all over the world. It is passed through by a river. It is very important for the architecture and for the monuments. And it is a really beautiful place to visit when you will have the possibility to also to be with us here at La Cividina.
Christian, you haven't shared any screen.
Eugene, do you hear me?
Yes, I do. But I think I lost you, but I can hear you. Can you hear me? Christian? Widi, bisa dengar?
Iya. Yeah.
Kayaknya nggak nyambung ya ke Christian.
Christian, can you hear us? I think Christian is having some trouble with the network.
Yeah, I think so too.
Okay, maybe while waiting for Christian, if anyone in the meeting room would like to ask any questions, maybe kita tampung dulu questionsnya while we're waiting for Christian to come back. Okay, Christian is back. Christian, you have to unmute your audio first. Okay.
Sorry, I had a trouble with the connection. Something is something broke. I don't know. I don't know which part you missed, but I was telling that La Cividina is the road that connects Rome to Cividale. That is a very beautiful small town, only 20 kilometers from here, where the UNESCO protect very important art pieces, very important and ancient architecture, and it's a really beautiful place to visit.
Let's see. Okay. Do we have any other questions from the people here? Widi, is there any question?
We don't have any questions from YouTube. For everyone in the meeting room, if you would like to ask any questions, please turn on the video and then you can ask the question straight away to Christian. Anyone?
So Christian, 1 year is pretty fast in developing design, right?
Yeah, 1 year is pretty fast, but the type of technologies and the materials that we use in our products let we have very, very fast development, because the woodworking, on the structures is very easy to do when you develop the prototype. The people that works in the prototype division in our company has very good skills in deciding the characteristics and the shapes of the frames and of the structures. And then, yeah, it's pretty fast, but every year we are able to develop three to five new collections. And then we are happy because we do not need to develop more, because usually we have two, three new partnership with designers with three to five new products. And yeah, it's pretty fast, but we are ready to face very challenging projects.
So it's very adaptive and very quick.
Yeah.
Okay, it's very interesting. Okay, is there any more questions?
About technology, about the app, the configurator, about the BIM, because from the website you can download all the BIM files. About the acoustics, if somebody have some question about acoustics, I don't know, about also the partnership with designers. We, in 2021, we will show a very exciting partnership with brand new interior design studios and designers. Very, very exciting.
So how do you develop the features in material?
So, sorry, Eugene, I missed.
Okay, so how do you develop the features for the furnitures? I mean, like the material, do you research and develop it inside La Cividina, or do you work with others, or how?
No, for the materials, we usually decide the shape of the frames, and then together with our partner for the wooden frames, we together with him decide the type of the wood that is best for that type of frame, because you can use pine, you can use oak, you can use beech, depends. And then the frame usually is decided together with a specialist of, with a carpenter that is specialist on wood and wooden frames. On the other side, with the foams, the Puritan foams, we have only one supplier for all our foams that is, I think, the best, the well-known all over the world, that is Olmo. Is one of the best manufacturers, and together with him we decided that different densities on the different places of the product to let you have the best comfort in the seating, but also the best durability and the best lifetime of the product. The fabrics and everything is completely made in Italy. Consider that La Cividina is still today the first and the only upholstery company that is certified made in Italy. And then we have a certification that really well explain that we use only materials that are manufactured in Italy, and we manufacture everything in Italy. Only for the fabrics, for the textiles, we need to go abroad and to buy fabrics from the best manufacturers like Quadrat, Vescom, Gabriel, Rohi, instead of Rubelli, and then many years ago, also Italy was a good place where there were very good manufacturers of fabrics. Nowadays, not. Nowadays is not anymore a good. Is not anymore a place where there are good manufacturers of upholstering fabrics.
I see. Okay. We have one question from the YouTube. Question: will design made by human be replaced by artificial intelligence design in the future, or will the price of human-made design will be more precious to the mass?
I think that in the future we will not never substitute the intelligence, the value of the culture, of the thoughts, of the moods and the feelings that everybody has in our lifestyle, in our design, in our design capacities. There will not be any technology, there will not be any artificial intelligence that could substitute the human mind to develop good design. I'm sure about this, I'm really sure, because if you go through the history, if you go through the centuries, the best things that you can find in every different age becomes from the human kind and comes from the human mind. And then I think that there will not be good design from intelligence, artificial intelligence. On the other side, it could be a good substitution of certain types of jobs, but the feeling, the touch that you have with your hands on the surface of a good upholstered furniture product, it is only human. And then it will be very, very difficult that in made in Italy and handmade furniture could be a competitor that is an artificial intelligence. Very difficult.
I agree with you. Human.
Yeah.
We cannot replace human with machine. Different. Okay. We've come to the end of our session for tonight. Do you have any closing remark, Christian?
I hope I usually have myself, I usually face the difficulties as opportunities. I hope that also this situation that we are living nowadays with the COVID could be an opportunity to pay more attention to the lifestyle, to the environment of our planet, to pay more attention on the quality of the products that we would like to have with us during our lifestyle, our journey in our life, and then could be an opportunity to protect in some ways the traditional materials that we can use in production instead of plastic, instead of something that after the lifetime of the product could be waste that we do not be able to recycle, we do not able to reuse. Consider that all our products are completely recyclable. And then, I don't know, but I think that also this situation, this COVID could be an opportunity in also in our field to pay more attention, to be more open to spend something more in quality, something more in good products and good materials.
I agree with you. I think this moment with the COVID all over makes us more aware and pay attention more to how we live, how we do something, and how we and how the things that we produce and the trash we produce a lot of trash this year's, and maybe this time with COVID and people become more aware or aware about themselves, about their behavior and what product they use in their lives, and about the furniture, like you say about the furniture, about the sustainability. Also, I understand, I agree also with the sentence that you mentioned beginning of this sessions about design is not just about the aesthetic, but it's all it's a combination, accumulations of many aspects, and about we the person that use the product and the responsibility. That's why all the product that you design connect with the sustainability and the well-being human. I think that's it from me. Get back to Widi.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you, Mas Eugene. It was an amazing presentation. Thank you very much. So I guess I have to close this program for tonight. For everyone's in the meeting room, please stay for a while. We'll have a private session after this. Okay, so thank you, everyone. Again, thank you, Christian. Thank you, Mas Eugene. This session was brought to you by Museum Macan and BWI, also for our partners, Institut Teknologi Bandung, Bandung Creative City Forum, Asosiasi Desainer Produk Industri Indonesia, and Himpunan Industri Interior Indonesia. And also, this program is powered by Cisco. So that's it for tonight. Thank you, everyone who's watching with us on YouTube. Good night, and have a good weekend. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Christian.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.